I cried. I'm not gonna hold y'all. Like, you know, a bad bitch said some tears. Hey bosses, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Candice Renee. In today's video, we're gonna be doing a life update chit chat video. I'm gonna be transparent and tell you guys everything that's kind of going on in my life right now and what's coming forward with the channel, my business, and everything like that. So if you guys want to be nosy and know what I got going on in my life, and you guys just want to know what's going on with me, y'all just want to be in my business, just keep on watching the video update, because I am not gonna be doing Vlogmas this year. I know that, like, everybody's favorite YouTuber, every YouTuber, mama, daddy, sister, cousin, brother, auntie, sister-in-law, cat, dog, all them is doing Vlogmas, and I will not be participating in Vlogmas this year. I know y'all sad, but I'm gonna try to get as much videos as I can out this month. So, ooh, excuse me. So the reason why I'm not doing Vlogmas is because I'm going to be very busy this month, y'all. So I'm gonna be busy. I start real estate school tomorrow. So if you guys didn't know, I am in the process of trying to get my real estate license. This is my second time taking the class. So I failed the class the first time. Well, I didn't really fail. I failed the class test. So I can take the class over for free within a year, as long as I take it within a year of the first class. So this is my second go around. I'm taking the accelerated class. So the accelerated class is only for 2 weeks. The first class I took was the slower class, which was like a month and 3 weeks, but I'm not finna go through that again. So I am taking the second class for it's only for 2 weeks. An accelerated class is like from 9 to 5, so it's the intense accelerator class. So I am taking this class. I'm taking this because I really want to get my real estate license. I want to get a license in something. I do have my business, I have YouTube, but I'm the type of person where it's like I always want something to fall back on. Like, okay, God forbid, if this don't work, then I got this. If this don't work, I got this. So it's like so many different things I want to do, and real estate is something that I want to get into. As you guys know, if you new to my channel or if you've been on my channel, you guys know that I do real estate investing. So I have flipped a couple of properties, but I want to actually like sell it and like be like official with the shit, you know what I'm saying? So I really want to get into being a real estate agent, and I feel like I don't want to like give up, because I could have easily gave up, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I'm gonna be so transparent with y'all, because again, I'm letting y'all in my business. So I want to be transparent with y'all. Like, I did cry when I failed the class, because like I was just like, damn, like I really tried so hard, and you know, and I was just like, I cried because I'm like, damn, I really got to do this all over again, take the class all over again. Because if you fail in Georgia, if you fail the class, you know, if you fail the class test 2 times, then you have to take the entire class over. So I failed the class test 2 times, so I have to take the whole class over. And it was like, I really felt like I was like sad as fuck. Like, I cried. I'm not gonna hold y'all. Like, you know, a bad bitch said some tears. But you know, I was like, I'm not gonna give up, because that's one thing I'm not gonna do. Because I used to be a negative person when I was younger, and I used to always be like, man, fuck this shit, I'm not doing this, da da da. But when you really want something, you have to keep going, and that's me. Like, I'm gonna keep going, and I'm not gonna stop. I'm not gonna give up, no matter how hard it is, because I didn't come this far to stop right here. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not gonna give up on me and what I want. I started this journey, and I'm gonna fucking finish it. Period. Period. Oh, also y'all, I did my own hair. Let me know if you guys in the comments like my hair. I did my own hair, y'all. Your girl is trying to save money. As y'all know, I am saving up to put this big ass down payment on my house, and I'll talk about that in a second. But y'all know, I'm trying to save up to put this big ass down payment on my house. So one thing that I'm trying to do is really like money management. I'm like, okay, what can I start cutting out of my life, because I'm spending too much money. And I was like, I used to do my own wigs back in the day, back when I was a broke bitch, like when I was like really broke as fuck, like I mean broke, like I couldn't even like put gas in my car type broke. when I first had my first apartment, I was working 9 to 5 and I couldn't really like afford to do nothing. I stopped getting my nails done. Like, this was back when a girl was struggling, okay? And this is when I had stopped selling hair and I just started struggling. So I learned how to do my own hair. I used to make my own wigs back in the day. And I kind of stopped. Like, once I got some money, I was like, I ain't doing my own hair no more. I'm about to start going to get my hair done, da da da. But then I realized that that shit starts to add up. Like, it really starts to add up when you go get your hair done all the time. Like, and I really was just sitting down like, why am I paying $200 to $250 to $280 to these hairstylists for something that's only gonna last for like 2 weeks, and then I'm gonna have to reinstall it myself? So I'm like, shoot, let me just start doing my own hair again. So I got this wig from a wholesale vendor in Georgia, in Atlanta. I really don't know how they are yet. This is my first time trying them. This is not from my normal vendor. It's a long story what happened to the wig from my normal vendor. I finally got the wig, but FedEx was playing on my top. That's it. But I had to get another wig real quick because I do start school tomorrow, so I needed something done on my head. I was working them straight backs, girl, looking like Set It Off. I couldn't walk around like that no more. So I had to get a wig real quick. I found this wholesale vendor. They are based in Atlanta. Like, they actually have a showroom and a store. You can go buy the hair, touch the hair. And this is my first time trying them. I like the wig so far. I've only had it in for like, what's today, Sunday? Today is Sunday. I installed this wig Friday. So yeah, I installed this wig Friday. So this is the wig. And I didn't film it, y'all. I did not film it. But I have another wig that I'm gonna install once I take this wig out. So I'm gonna definitely do an install video for y'all if y'all like my hair. If y'all like my hair, I'll do an install video for y'all, for real, for real. Shout out to YouTube University, because that's how I learned how to do this. Honestly, like, I think I did a really good job. Because back in the day, my wigs, they wasn't like horrible, but they was not like the best. Okay, but that's enough about my hair. So next topic is my house. So you guys know that I am getting a house. If you guys watched my vlog from a couple of weeks ago, I did put a down payment on the house. Everything is cool with the house. Everything's cool. I'll probably insert a picture somewhere of a picture of my lot. I went and took my mom by the lot because she knows the neighborhood I'm moving into, but she never seen the lot. So we went by it yesterday and I just kind of showed her where it was at, and we kind of just looked around the neighborhood and we talked to like the homeowner people, homeowner association, because there's some people who do live in the neighborhood, and just asked them like, you know, can I build a fence and all that stuff like that. So we were just talking to some homeowner association people, and yeah. So that's what we did yesterday. So I'm gonna insert the picture so y'all can see the lot. It's just dirt and two sticks right now. They don't start building my house until January, and it should be done. The estimate is May of 2022, so next year. It should be done by May. They said it could possibly be done sooner, but I'm gonna definitely take you guys on that entire journey. Like, every time I go visit it, I can go visit the house and see their progress and stuff. I'm probably gonna start doing that in like February, so I will definitely take y'all on the journey of me building a house. And then once the whole process is complete, I will definitely do a YouTube video about how to buy your first home, everything that you need to buy your first home and everything like that once I get done with my process. But yeah, y'all will definitely be on that journey with me. What else? My business. Okay, so let's talk about my business and how I'm rebranding. So you guys know I have a business called Renee Society. Renee Society is where I sell my merch, my Depression to Deposit t-shirts. I also sell ebooks and stuff like that. So I am rebranding that business, which is another reason why I'm not doing Vlogmas, is because I am trying to work on rebranding my business right now. So I'm gonna be transparent with y'all again, and I'm gonna be real with y'all and really just express the L's that I have taken these past couple of days. Excuse me. Oof. That casserole I just ate. Oof. Anyway, just express the L's that I have taken. So, you know, I'm always about being transparent, being real with y'all. My Black Friday sale actually did not do what I wanted it to do. I'm gonna be honest with y'all, it did not do what I wanted it to do. It didn't do what I wanted it to do. Sales have been kind of slow these past few weeks, I'm not gonna lie. They picked up they picked up for a minute, and then they kind of slowed a little bit, picked up then slowed, but around Black Friday time they were actually kind of slow. And so I just was kind of like, okay, I feel like something told me that I need a rebrand, because I'm like, okay, my business will pick up, then it will slow down, then it will pick up, then it'll slow down, then it'll be slow for a minute, pick up. Like, I wanted to continuously pick up, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, okay, so for some reason I feel like I need a rebrand. Like, I feel like that I need to change the whole purpose of my business and everything about my business, around my business, like just everything period about my business. So I'm keeping my name and I'm keeping my colors, but I'm going in a different direction. I really want to focus a lot more. So I do still are focusing on entrepreneurs, but I kind of am changing the niche. I'm kind of changing my niche of my business. So instead of focusing on social media tips, social media marketing and branding and stuff like that, I'm really kind of putting the focus on how to deal with certain things in entrepreneurship. So I'm not really sure what to call myself. I did speak to a business coach. I did. I actually had a coaching session with a coach because I wanted a second opinion on my rebrand. So I know I always talk shit about business coaches, but sometimes they really are good for some things. And I had a coaching session with this coach because I already had an idea for my rebrand, but I kind of like wanted somebody who was higher up than me in the business world to kind of like give me some pointers and advice on how to actually execute the idea. So I actually did get on a coaching call with a coach that's actually a really reputable coach, and a really good coach, somebody that I've worked with in the past that's actually really giving good advice. And she actually kind of told me like what direction to go into, and I looked into it and I really like the niche of how I kind of want this to go. So basically what Renee Society is that basically for my business now, what I'm going to be doing is helping entrepreneurs overcome certain obstacles in their life to help them reach that level of success. So I think I'm like a lifestyle coach now. I don't really know what to call it yet. I don't want to say life coach, maybe business development coach, lifestyle coach. I don't really have a title yet. I'm still like getting into this niche. But basically what I'm going to be doing is helping entrepreneurs really step into what it is that they're trying to do in their life, overcome the certain obstacles, because a lot of people don't talk about obstacles that entrepreneurs go through. So entrepreneurs may go through depression, they may go through sadness, they may go through loss of job, a loss of a loved one, a heartbreak. How, as an entrepreneur, do I deal with those issues and turn it into something that will benefit my business and help me reach that level of success that I'm trying to get to? Because I personally did it myself. That's the whole thing behind depression to deposits. So depression to deposits really means, turn my depression to deposits really means that I overcame a dark time in my life. I overcame a dark time in my life and I turned it into something positive. I turned it into a business, a career. So it doesn't always have to mean like, oh, I was depressed, because it doesn't always have to mean that. It just means you took a dark time in your life. So you could have been really sad, or you could have lost a job. You could have went broke. You could have lost a house. You could have lost a loved one, a heartbreak, something. And you took that low point in your life and you turned it around and turned it into a career, a business, whatever it is that you have going for yourself. You've reached that level of success. And so that is where I'm kind of going with my business now. I want it to be more of entrepreneur development and like business owner development, and stuff like that, instead of just like teaching marketing tips, business tips, all that stuff. I want to start really teaching business entrepreneur development, developing you as a business owner, developing you as a person. And I felt like this niche would go so great with what it is that I'm actually coming up with. So you guys know I have depression to deposits. I just told y'all what that means. So it kind of like that whole thing just kind of like ties into it. So that's really the direction now that I'm going into with my business. And that's kind of what I want to do with my business. So I guess it's kind of like a lifestyle coach, a lifestyle development coach, because I know all too well about this and I want to help other entrepreneurs really overcome what they overcome. So of course you guys know I have my merch and my journals. So You guys know I introduced these journals back in another video, and I have noticed that some of you guys, because I can see everything that y'all do on my website, by the way, y'all know I be lurking on y'all just a little bit be lurking, but it's for research purposes only, okay? I gotta know what's up, you know, I gotta watch them analytics. But I have noticed that some of y'all have went to my website and tried to search this. This is not available yet, you guys. As of Sunday, December 5th, 2021, this is not available on Renee Society website yet. This will not be available until next year. These journals will not be available until 2022, y'all. So you guys, if you guys want the Future Millionaire Thoughts journals, please follow Renee Society on Instagram. That's my business page, or you can follow my personal page, or really follow both. Like, let's just follow both. Let's be connected. But no, follow one of my pages and you guys will get all the updates on when these will drop. But these will not drop until next year. So make sure to be on the lookout for that. And that is pretty much it about what is going on in my life. If you guys enjoyed this video, let me know if you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And just know that more videos are coming. And if you guys have any video ideas that you guys have for me, anything that you guys want me to talk about, anything that you guys want me to do, say, let me know. Vlogs will be coming, you guys. I'm not leaving YouTube. You guys won't see me as much as you guys see me before, but I'm definitely still gonna be posting videos. So please stay rocky with me, y'all. You girls just trying to get our life together. So please stay rocky with me, y'all. But I appreciate y'all. I love y'all so much. Thank you for all of my subscribers, all 4,000 and I don't know how many subscribers. I know it's 4,000 something. But I love y'all so much. Thank y'all so much for watching this video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next video. 1995, I found out that I was going to make